Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, I am Ahmed Mumtaz Mustason, your teacher for CSC 141 Introduction to Computer Programming. We start the next lecture with the thanks to Dr. Sadaf Tanveer, Assistant Professor, for providing me the slide material and some lecture material. Dear students, you remember that we talked about operators. We talked about different categories of operators: assignment operators, arithmetic operators, relational operators, logical operators, bitwise operators, and I explained quite a few and promised you to explain all these operators as and when required. Today I have decided to discuss the most important concept in programming, which is called if construct. In the if construct, we are required to use these relational operators and these logical operators. So let's have a very quick review of these operators. So first of all, relational operators, less than, you know, when we have to compare two values together, whether A is equal to B, less than B, greater than B, less than equal to B, greater than equal to B, or not equal to B. Also remember that two equality operators, two equal sign operators, when they are used in pair, they depicts or they defined equal operator or the equality operator. And when we use this equal operator sign with sign of exclamation, then it is called not equal. And when we use this equal operator single, then it is considered as assignment operator. So let us take a quick review of this example where I have initialized I is equal to 1. Then we have used clear screen function. This clear screen function is a built-in function of C language that facilitates you to clear the output window. Whatever garbage or whatever output already available on the output window, you can clean it and you can have a fresh output window where you can place the result of your current program. So it's a very useful built-in function available. We'll talk about it more functions when we will be discussing the functions. So next two statements are printf statements. We have already discussed printf statements along with its arguments, along with format specifier, escape sequence, and the data elements which are required to be printed onto the console. So quickly, is I less than 0, percentage d, backslash n, double quotes end, comma, I equal 0. How can we interpret this sequence, this list? First of all, is I less than 0 is a string that will be printed as it is on the console. Percentage d is a format specifier that indicates that any integer data is to be printed here, and that integer data should be the first one in the list after this first argument. Backslash n, this backslash n is an escape sequence that represents new line. Okay, so the first argument is I equal 0. I equal 0 is an equality operator that tests whether I is equal to 0. Now there can be two answers, yes or no. In case we say I equal to 0, if it is true, the answer will be yes. And how do we represent yes? Yes is represented by non-zero value. So the output will be equal to 1. But if it is false, then the output should be equal to 0. Since we have initialized I is equal to 1, therefore I equal 0 is true or false? It is false. Therefore, you can see The system will print, is I less than 0? Question mark. The answer is 0, means it is false. The same question is repeated, but this time we have put a check, i equal 1. Since we have initialized the initial value of I equal to 1, therefore I is yes equal to 1. The answer is true. True is non-zero, which is equal to 1. Therefore, the answer will be equal to 1. The purpose here is just to show you that you can test two values, or you can test any value with any corresponding value that you can provide as an R value. But the R value and L value, we use it with a assignment operator. When we use it as an equality operator, then we are comparing the two values. And whenever we compare the two values, the answer is either 1 means true, 0 means false. So aapka jawab hoga 1 ya 0 means true or false. Okay. So in the last example, we have tested the value of I with equality operator. Now we will test the same thing, but this time we will test it with an less than inequality operator. So I is less than 0. Rest is the same. We have I initialized the initial value of I equal to 1. So is I is less than 0? Answer is no. Answer is false. It's not true because I is equal to 1. So the output should be equal to false. Or false ki output kya hoti hai? 0. That's why in the first line, output is I less than 0? Answer is 0. Means ke I jo hai, wo 0 se less nahi hai. Why? Because we have initialized the value of I equal to 1. Next time, next line, is I greater than 0? Is I greater than 0? Yes, because we have initialized I is equal to 1. Therefore, answer is true. And if the answer is true, then it will give you the output non-zero, which is equal to 1. So, is I greater than 0 is equal to 1. So, we have used both equality operators, equal equality operator and the less than and greater than operators. Precedence of these operators. If I would like to use arithmetic operators along with this relational operators, suppose in the upper example, I said answer percentage D backslash N comma 2 plus 1 less than 4. What is 2 plus 1 less than 4? Kya kehte hain ise? Yes, it is called expression. It is an expression. 2 plus 1 is less than 4. This expression is going to be evaluated. Why it is going to be evaluated? Because we are using a relational operator. We are using a relational operator. Okay, so 2 plus 1 is less than 4. What is the precedence? If we compare the precedence of arithmetic operator versus relational operator, then the arithmetic operator operators have the higher precedence. So iska kya matlab hua ki 2 plus 1 will be evaluated first. 2 plus 1, answer is 3. Is 3 less than 4? Yes, 3 is less than 4. Therefore, the answer, the output should be equal to 1. Next, 1 is less than 2 plus 4. Now, which part will be evaluated first? The part that contains arithmetic operator, which is plus, means 2 plus 4 will be evaluated first. 2 plus 4, the answer is 6. So it will be 1 less than 6? Yes, 1 is less than 6. Therefore, the answer is equal to 1. So what we have learned? Up to now, we have seen that we can use equality operators. Do values ko compare karne ke liye, hum equal ka sign use kar sakte hain. We can use greater than operator. We can use less than operator. Then in this particular example, not only we have used the relational operator, but we have combined it with the arithmetic operator. And we have seen that the arithmetic operator has the higher precedence, therefore 2 plus 1 will be evaluated first, then it will be compared with 4. Similarly, 2 plus 4 that contains an arithmetic operator will be evaluated first, then it will be compared with 1. Okay? Aage chale. Decision construct. Ye relational operators humne define kiye hain because I want to use it in the decision construct. Anywhere in the life or any time you encountered a situation where you are required to take the decision. For example, when you get up from your bed, so you just check the time and see what is the time. If you are getting it from your class, you have to take the decision. You take the decision, okay, I'm going to skip the lunch. So you decide, you encounter a situation where you are required to take the decision. Similarly, if you are going from the from one city to another city, then you see that, okay, if the motorway is closed, what alternate you have, then you might require to take the Grand Trunk Road, GT Road. So if one way is closed, then you would like to go through the other way out. Okay. Similarly, in programming, you compare and you encountered a situation, test a situation and take the decision accordingly. For that purpose, we have got a very, very powerful feature available in the programming language, which is called if construct. This if construct has got multiple combinations, variety of combinations. So we will discuss all these one by one, step by step. Gradually, we'll keep on exploring the advanced features of the if constructs. So start karte. Suppose we have defined a character CH, char. Remember, there are five data types. Kaun-kaun se? Integer, double, float, character, void. Basic ye paanch hi hain. Then हमने देखा था कुछ modifiers पढ़े थे जिसमें हमने long को पढ़ा था और उसके बाद signed, unsigned, but basic data types जो हैं वो हैं 5. So character CH, clear screen. CH is equal to get CH. वैसे get CH भी एक function होता है. जब हम सारे functions पढ़ेंगे तो मैं आपको get CH और get CHE दोनों का difference बताऊंगा. Today we say CH is equal to get CH. ये एक built-in function है. Get CH is a built-in function available in C and C++ that helps you reading a character from the keyboard. Whatever character you press on the keyboard, you can read it out with the help of this get CH function. Get CH function जो है उस character को read करता है और return back करता है. जब उस करैक्टर को रिटर्न करता है तो यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू स्टोर दैट करैक्टर इन ए करैक्टर डेटा टाइप. दैट्स व्हाई वी हैव डिफाइंड CH एज ए करैक्टर. सो व्हाटएवर करैक्टर यू विल प्रेस, इट विल बी सेव्ड इन CH. नेक्स्ट, अब ये इफ स्टेटमेंट है. यू हैव गॉट इफ, देन यू हैव गॉट पैरेंथेसिस. हियर यू हैव अ टेस्ट स्टेटमेंट वेयर यू से इफ CH इक्वल y. Whenever we compare a single character, you remember, मैंने आपसे कहा था, we use single quote. तो यहाँ पर y को compare कर रहे हैं with the contents in CH. जो भी आपने keyboard से character को press किया था, उसको CH में मौजूद है. And now you are comparing that character with y. And if it is equal to y, if this condition is true, then and only then, the next statement, the statement which is the body of the if statement, jis tarah for loop ki body hoti hai na, isi tarah if statement ki bhi body hai. Since the body contains only one statement, so we are not required to enclose it into the braces or enclose it into the curly brackets. To yahan par printf you typed y, or if you don't type y, अगर आप कुछ और y की जगह प्रेस करते हैं, then it will not execute. Next, get CH is once again, it's a dummy statement that is just to keep the output window there as if it is waiting for some input. As long as you press any character on the keyboard, and since you are not doing with that particular character, the character will be read by the getCHE and your program is terminated. So you can see the output of this particular program. If you type Y, so it will write you typed Y. Okay, shabash. Next, let's take a practice exercise. I'm posing a question. By purchasing certain items, a store offers a discount of 10% if the quantity purchased is more than 1000. अगर आप कोई भी आइटम 1000 से ज़्यादा परचेज करेंगे, क्वांटिटी नॉट द प्राइस, अगर कोई भी क्वांटिटी किसी भी आइटम को 1000 से ज़्यादा परचेज करेंगे तो स्टोर विल ऑफर यू 10% डिस्काउंट ऑफ द होल प्रोडक्ट और होल क्वांटिटी दैट यू हैव बॉट. सो वी आर रिक्वायर्ड टू राइट अ प्रोग्राम दैट इनपुट द क्वांटिटी एंड प्राइस पर आइटम थ्रू द कीबोर्ड and calculate the amount to be charged from the customers. Okay, hum type karenge, suppose 1200, the price of per item is 10 rupees, so we need to find out ke isko discount dena hai ya nahi dena. Agar dena hai, then how much discount is offered and how much price should be charged. First of all, I'd like to discuss the flow chart depicting this particular situation. You start a program, by default the discount is 0%. Remember, you are required to input two items. One is quantity, second is the rate. So quantity comma rate, then you put a decision box. This is basically if construct here that check if quantity is greater than 1000. If yes, it will go to the right side where the discount is 10. Otherwise, no, then the discount remains the same, means the discount remains zero. From both sides, you will come back to the next statement. And here you compute the total quantity multiplied by the rate माइनस डिस्काउंट. अब डिस्काउंट कैसे कैलकुलेट कर रहे हैं, क्वांटिटी मल्टीप्लाई बाय द रेट मल्टीप्लाई बाय डिस्काउंट ओवर 100. दिस इज परसेंटेज डिस्काउंट. इन केस यू हैव फॉलोड द पाथ फ्रॉम द लेफ्ट साइड दैट द क्वांटिटी इज लेस देन 1000, देन द डिस्काउंट इज जीरो. व्हेन यू मल्टीप्लाई एनीथिंग विद जीरो, इट्स जीरो, सो यू सब्ट्रैक्ट अ जीरो फ्रॉम द रेट, मीन्स नो डिस्काउंट. But if you are coming from the right side, then the discount is equal to 10. So you subtract this quantity, multiply by rate, multiply by 10, divide by 100. So whatever the rate is, it is providing us a discount of 10%. That is subtracted from the price of the items, number of items we have procured. We print the result and stop. So let's write a program for that. Calculation of the payment to be charged from the customers. So we defined some initial variables, quantity, discount. By default, I said the discount should be equal to zero. Float, rate and total. Why I've used rate and total as float? Because we can expect that the price of the item could be in real, might contain a decimal point. So if a unit price contains some decimal point, so then your total should, or total may contain a decimal point. So therefore we have defined the two variables rate and total in float. Then printf, enter quantity and rate. This is just a message that will be printed on the output window to caution you, to inform you that the system is waiting for the input. Now you will use the next statement, which is called scanf. Scanf kisve use karte to read the data from the keyboard. Aur aapko maine bataya tha ki when you are required to input two quantities and the scanf is required to read the two or more than one quantities, how can we separate the multiple quantities? Do you remember that? Yes, it should either be comma or a space or a tab or a new line. You can use enter character also. Okay, so the system will read the quantity and the rate. Then you can put a check if quantity greater than 1000, then the discount is equal to 10. Okay, ab aap dekhenge ki body of the if construct just contains one single statement, therefore we have not used any curly bracket. Then we compute total is equal to quantity multiplied by the rate minus quantity multiplied by the rate multiplied by discount divided by 100. So here you can give a 10% discount and then you can print out the result. Okay, so suppose enter quantity and rate. Suppose you have entered 1200 item purchase kiye hain customer ne and the price is 10 rupees per item. So 1200 and 10.0, the price you can simply calculate very quickly should be 12,000 rupees. Lekin humne price charge ki hai 10,800 rupees. Why? Because the quantity is greater than 1000, therefore there is a discount of 10%. So we have computed a discount from 12,000 rupees. The 10% of 12,000 is how much? 1200 rupees. So we have given a discount of 1200 rupees and this is computed by our program. In the next example, we repeated the same program again. This time the quantity is 200, the rate is 15 rupees. So we have simply multiplied it 15 with 200. The answer is 3000, no discount. You might have noticed an odd thing in this program, which is there are four zeros after decimal place. Okay, that's the point where you can use a format specifier with decimal point. Okay, we can use 0.2f, then it will only print two digits after the decimal. Okay, but if you don't use this, then by default it will print four or maybe six digits after decimal places. Okay, so it's up to you, since the price should not have more than two digits, so it doesn't look nice, so you should use the format specifier accordingly. This is just to show you that if your if construct contains more than two statements in its body, yani ke if ki jo body hai, if it contains more than two statements, then like for loop, body of the for loop, we are required to enclose it in the curly bracket, jinko hum braces bhi kehte hain. So just to give you some example, I've used directly a statement, if year of service is greater than 3, okay, bonus is equal to 2500 and we print f bonus is equal to rupees percent d bonus. Please remember there is no semicolon here, no semicolon here. It is not there. Okay, so I'll give you the details that what will happen if you by mistake put a semicolon over there. Next, if else statement. This is another flavor of if construct. We can combine if with else statement. When if condition evaluates to be true, the group of statements under if are executed. यानी कि जब आपने एक टेस्ट किया और अगर वो टेस्ट ट्रू हो गया तो वट एवर ब्लॉक यू हैव प्लेस जस्ट आफ्टर द इफ टेस्ट, ओके, that block of statement will be executed. Next, it does nothing when the expression evaluates to false. Agar wo true nahi hoga, to statement execute nahi hogi. But if we want to let the system do something, if the one construct is true, then it will execute the upper body. If it is not false, then it should use another block of the body. If you want to do that, then you can combine if with else. We can do something when the if condition evaluates to false using the else statement. Kaise? Let us see an example. Once again, I'll pose a question. In a company, an employee pay is computed as follows. That if the basic salary of the employee is less than 1500, then human resource allowance is equal to 10% of the basic salary, and daily allowance is equal to 90% of the basic salary. But if the salary is greater than 1500, then human resource allowance is equal to 500 rupees, it's a fixed, and the daily allowance is 98% of the basic salary. Okay. If the employee salary is input through the keyboard, write a program to find his gross salary. Ab aapne kya karna hai? Ek program likhna hai. That program should read the salary of an employee and compute its gross salary. How can we do that? Once again, let's see this flow chart. We start, we take the input. Input kya hai? Basic salary, BS. BS stands for basic salary. We read the basic salary, and if we say its basic salary is less than 1500, then it's other way around. I'm sorry, it should be what is the question? Let us see. Read the question again. The question says that if the salary is less than 1500, then HR allowance is 10%. So here we are computing. So if the salary is less than 1500, so we can say yes, it should be like this. And if we say no, then it should use this path. Okay. So there was a mistake in the slide. So is basic salary is less than 1500, then HRA is equal to basic salary multiplied by 10%. And daily allowance is basic salary multiplied by 90%. But if the basic salary is not less than 1500, it is equal to or greater than 1500, then it will come from the other side. Now, in the previous example, when this if construct was true, it executed the set of statement. If it was false, it was doing nothing. Kaise? I'll just take you back. Yeah. If the if construct was true, it does something here. But if the if construct was false, it did nothing. Yahan par isne kuch nahi kiya. But here, we want that the if it is true, then it should do something, and if it is false, yet it should do something. Agar aisi situation hai jahan pe true ki surat mein hum ek kaam karwana chahte hain, false ki surat mein hum dusra kaam karwana chahte hain. For example, if you are going through the motorway, if the motorway is available, then you should fill up your tank with petrol. Suppose the CNG gas is not available on the motorway. So you will fill up your tank of your vehicle. Aapki car ka jo tank hai, usko aap petrol dalwayenge. If the motorway is closed, is not available for some reasons, you are going through GT road, Grand Trunk Road, and we assume that on the Grand Trunk Road, the CNG is available. So you will fill out the CNG in your car. So depending upon the situation, you do either one types of activity or the other type of activity, and that is depicted here. So jo employees jinki salary less than 1500 hai, unka HR jo hai is computed here and daily allowance is computed here. And employees who have the salary greater than equal to 500, their H and their daily allowance is here. And both cases, then you combine the basic salary plus HR plus daily allowance and you get the gross salary and print the gross salary and stop. So let us write a program for that. We initialize float, basic, gross salary, daily allowance, human resource allowance, HRA. Please enter basic salary because that was the only input that we were supposed to read from the keyboard. We read it with the scanf. Remember, scanf ke saath, the variable here does not contain ampersand sign. So, ye ampersand sign kahan se aaya? Do you remember that? Yes, it is the address operator. It is the requirement of this scanf function that we use address operator with each variable for which we are required to read the data from the keyboard. Okay, after reading this, now here there is no ampersand sign. Ye sirf aur sirf hume read time ke upar uske address operator variable se proceed karta hai. Theek hai? Start hota hai variable with ampersand sign. Okay, but whenever you use the variable, we don't use this ampersand sign here. So here we just put a test. If basic salary is less than 1500, then we compute human resource allowance 10% of the basic salary. Then we compute daily allowance, which is 90%. If it is true, basic salary is less than this one, then this part of this body of if construct will be executed. Else, if it is not true, means the salary is equal to or greater than 1500, that is else. Here, once again, there are two statements, so we need to put two curly brackets here. So we say the human resource allowance is equal to 500 and we compute, this is fixed, remember, agar less than 1500 ho, to 10%, or agar greater than ho, or greater than equal to 1500 ho, to fixed amount of 500 rupees, and then you compute 98% as a daily allowance. So HR or DA will be computed both here. If it is true, if it is false, then yet both will be computed here. The formula above is different. Yahan pe 10% hai, yahan pe 500 hai, yahan pe 90% hai, yahan pe 98%. So the formula is different, but yet we compute HR and DA in both the cases. Yahan pe petrol degi aur yahan par CNG degi. When we come out, we say, what do we have? We have a basic salary plus HRA plus DA. Human resource allowance, basic salary mein add ho raha hai, DA basic salary mein add ho raha hai. Or it is being done on both the cases. Then you can print the gross salary. Okay, so you have learned another flavor of if construct. I give you exercise. You do it by yourself. I'll give you the solution in the next lecture or maybe after a couple of lectures. And the solution will also be available on your web portal. An integer is input through a keyboard. Koi bhi integer keyboard se read kare and write a program to determine if the number is even or odd. This is your practice exercise, class practice exercise. You have to do it. Next, nested if else. Do you remember we discussed nested for loop? For loop ke andar humne for loop ke istemal ko kaha tha, nested for loop. Now we say that if ke andar if statement ko use kar rahe hain, we call it as a nested if statement. It is perfectly all right if we write an entire if else construct within either the body of the if statement or the body of an else statement. अभी क्या है? अभी हमने discuss किया कि if has got first of all a test. If it is true, then you have a body of if statement. If it is false, then the body of else statement. पहले ऊपर वाली body if की, उसके बाद body else की. So either it will execute the body of if or it will execute the body of else. तो हम if की body के अंदर if use कर सकते हैं दोबारा और else की body के अंदर फिर if use कर सकते हैं दोबारा. So if we use if statement within the body of if statement or within the body of else statement, then we call it as nested if. बिल्कुल ऐसे ही जैसे for की body के अंदर हम for loop को हमने दोबारा use किया था और हमने उसको nested for loop कहा था. Second, there is no limit on how deeply the ifs and elses can be nested. अब body के अंदर आपने if की body में if use किया, उसके अंदर फिर if और else आ गए, उसके अंदर फिर आप if use करवें, उसके अंदर फिर आप if use करवें. So there is no restriction, कोई theoretical restrictions नहीं है, पर थोड़ा clumsy हो जाएगा, बहुत ज़्यादा nesting करने से there will be few problems that I will discuss in few minutes, but theoretically there is no restriction. So if में if को use करने को हम कहते हैं nested if. आप उसको if की body में use करें या else की body में use करें. Let us take few examples for that. This is just a demo. You are required to input a number 1 or 2. आप से कहा जा रहा है कि आप enter करें keyboard से 1 enter करें या 2 enter करें. Okay, so we have initialized a variable integer int I and we say that printf please enter a number 1 or 2. Just choice hai aapke paas 1 enter kare hai 2 enter kare. You read it out with the help of scanf function, then we test. If I equal 1, you have entered 1. Ab dekhiye ye true hoga to sirf ye if wala part execute hoga, else wala part pe control aayega hi nahi. Aur यहां से कंट्रोल सीधा इफ कंस्ट्रक्ट से बाहर आ जाएगा. दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. सिमिलरली अगर ये फॉल्स होगा देन इट विल गो टू द एल्स पार्ट एंड इट विल एग्जीक्यूट व्हाटएवर इज रिटन इन द एल्स पार्ट. सपोज आई इज नॉट इक्वल टू 1 देन इट विल गो टू द एल्स पार्ट. हियर यू विल चेक इफ आई इज इक्वल टू 2. इफ यस इट विल प्रिंट यू हैव एंटर 2. But suppose you have neither entered 1 nor you have entered 2. So what will happen? It will not go here. It will not execute this statement and hence it will not print you have entered 1. Similarly, if you have not entered 2, it will not go here. Because this test, if it is true, then this body will be executed. If this test is true, then this body will be executed. Okay? So suppose you have entered 5. So it will not go here. Compare it with 2, it's not go here. So you say else, you print you have entered neither 1 nor 2. So aap dekhen ki humne if ke andar, if ki body ke andar nahi, balki else ki body ke andar humne ek aur if statement use ki hai. This if else construct we have used within the body of else statement. Okay? There are number of forms of if statements. Before I go to some more examples, let's इसको हम final करें और देखते हैं कि हमने अब तक क्या पढ़ा. सबसे पहले हमने पढ़ा if condition, then do this first format of the if statement. Second हमने पढ़ा if condition, then do this. A and B are same. What's the difference? In A, there was only one single statement and we are not required to put these two curvy brackets. In B, just like A, but the difference is that here we have got two statements. When we have got two statements in the body of the if or else, we are required to put the curvy brackets there. Third combination, if this condition is true, do this, else do this. दोनों में आपके पास एक एक स्टेटमेंट है. इफ द कंडीशन इज ट्रू इट विल एग्जीक्यूट दिस. इफ द कंडीशन इज फॉल्स इट विल एग्जीक्यूट दिस. सो इट विल एग्जीक्यूट आइदर दिस or this, not both, because we have got either the if is true. If it is not true, then means false, then it will execute do this. But if it is true, then it will do this. The same thing in D, if condition is true, you have got two statements, do this and this. Since there are two statements, so you are required to put two curly brackets here. In the else case, there are still two statements, so you are required to put a curly brackets here also. Next, here we'll be doing some nesting. Nested if. If condition is true, do this. Else, we used again if statement. If condition is true, do this. Else, do that. So this else part contains the, it's very interesting. Upper if ke andar kyunki sirf ek single statement hai, so we have not put these curly brackets here, but else wale part mein we have got two statements, so we have used a curly bracket here. So that shows you another unique combination. Finally, if the condition is true, you can use the if statement here. If this, do this, else, do that, and else, you can repeat, we use else again, else, do that. So if true, do this, else, do that, else, do that. Okay, so that is another combination of else statements. Before we do some more practice, let's talk about the logical operators also. अभी तक मैंने आपको इफ कंस्ट्रक्ट में वट एवर आई हैव टॉट आई हैव यूज द रिलेशनल ऑपरेटर्स देर आर लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर्स एज वेल एंड वट आर द लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर्स तीन लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर्स हैं हमारे पास विच आर बेसिकली एंड ऑपरेटर डबल एम्परसेंट साइन इज कॉल्ड एंड ऑपरेटर डबल पाइप इज कॉल्ड और ऑपरेटर एंड दिस sign of exclamation is called not operator. And operator is this, or operator is this, and not operator is this. Okay, these are the three operators. I'll take an example, that then I will come back again with this operators, because in the example you will better understand its usage. I'll explain it there, and then we'll talk about the theoretical concepts of the logical operator. Example: the marks obtained by a student in five different subjects are input through the keyboard. The student gets a division as per the following rules. If the percentage of the student or the average of the student is 60 or above, then it is first division. If the percentage is between 50 to 59, it is second division. If the percentage is between 40 to 49, it is third division. And less than 40 is fail. Write a program to calculate the division obtained by the student. Ab isme we would like to see how can we write this particular program. पहले हम प्रोग्राम लिखते हैं. Let us define the marks of the students. Let's assume के round off marks हैं integer m1, m2, m3, m4 and m5, and per is a variable name for percentage. ये क्या है? m1, m2, m3, m4, m5. आप देखिए, we were required to enter the result of five subjects. So humne five subjects ke five variables m1, m2, m3, marks for one, subject one, marks for subject two, marks for subject three, marks for subject four, marks for subject five, and percentage. Please enter marks in five subjects. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and address operator of marks 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Ye variables jo humne define kiye the address operators ke saath. We have entered these five. Remember, जब एक से ज़्यादा arguments हों, scan fk, तो how can you distinguish? आप data enter करें, उसके साथ tab, tab, tab करके data enter करते रहें, या data enter करें, first one, space bar, two, space bar, three, space bar, four, space bar, 5. Comma, comma 2, comma 3, comma 4, comma 5. Or enter 1, enter 2, enter 3, enter 4, and you will be able to enter 5. So these are called white spaces, and these white spaces can distinguish different key quantity entered on the keyboard. We compute the percentage average, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5. Suppose 100 में से marks हैं, percentage निकालना is very simple. उसको 5 पे divide कर दीजिए, 5 को add करके, you will find the percentage. If the percentage is greater than equal to 60, print first division. अगर ये construct true हो गया, तो system will not go this else. Okay, अगर ये इस else में नहीं जाएगा, तो इस else में, इस if statement में नहीं जाएगा. और अगर ये इसमें नहीं जाएगा, तो फिर इसमें जाएगा. Suppose इन सारे जितने भी constructs की bodies हैं, body number 1, body number 2, body number 3, the system will either enter here or here or here or, sorry, चौथी भी है ये. This is the fourth one. 4, 3, 2, I am writing with mouse, that's why you see that writing better than the class 1 student, I guess. Okay. So, else, if the percentage is greater than equal to 50, iska matlab hai ke 60 or 60 se above to hai nahi. So, next, if it is greater than 50, understood hai ki aap 50 or 59 kidhar mein aan ho sakti hai. If it is that, it will print second division and will come out of this. और अगर ये भी नहीं है, ये भी नहीं है, else में आएगा इधर, here it will check the percentage. Now, once again, if the percentage is greater than equal to 40, third division. और अगर ये भी नहीं है, किस्मत में लिखा है, then it is not किस्मत में लिखा है, but the result of the effort of the student means, if it is less than 40, means it is fail. Okay? So you can see that okay, you can have these all combinations and you can use the nested if statements wherever required and you can compute that. Let's talk about it a little more. We have seen that the program has used nested else statement. If else, per if else. This leads to three disadvantages. Number one, as the number of conditions go on increasing, agar aapke paas 10-12 grades hain, theek, to you will be required to put number of nested statements one after the other. Number two, care needs to be exercised to match the corresponding ifs and else. Har if ke saath uski else ko match karna hai, that's important. Aur isse bhi zyada important, care needs to be exercised to match the corresponding pair of braces. Varna ek ki body dusre mein mix ho jayegi. Ek statement ke baad dusri statement. And you will find some funny errors that you won't be able to debug or rectify easily. Usme aapko bahut arcrazy karni padegi. You will be required to put in lot of efforts to find out the errors if you make a mistake in matching the braces or matching the else statement with the if statements. So all these three problems can be eliminated or can be curtailed or contained if we use logical operators. Kaise? Let us see. Very interesting. Same program, but this time I would like to use some logical operators here. Two logical operators. In this example, I have used the relational operators. Combined it with relational operators. Same program. You have entered the marks of 5 subjects in M1, M2, M3, M4, M5. And you compute percentage, which is the average. M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus M4 plus M5 divided by 5 is the average, which is supposedly a percentage. If the percentage is greater than or equal to 60, print F first division. If it is not true, write down the next statement. If the percentage is greater than or equal to 50 and percentage is less than 60, yes, we have used a logical operator AND. और ये लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर जो है ये क्या बता रहा है कि हमने कहा है कि इफ द परसेंटेज इज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 50 और परसेंटेज इज लेस देन 60, इन दोनों को एंड कर दिया है हमने, इन दोनों क्वांटिटीज को एंड कर दिया है। नेस्टेड इफ हमने बचा ली है यहाँ पर इस लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर की मदद से। देन प्रिंट एफ सेकेंड डिवीजन, क्योंकि सेकेंड डिवीजन जो है वो कहता है कि इफ योर मार्क्स आर ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 50 एंड लेस देन 60, यानी कि 50 और 50 से ज़्यादा और 60 से कम होंगे इस विंडो के अंदर, इस रेंज के अंदर मार्क्स होंगे, देन यू विल बी अवॉर्डेड सेकेंड डिवीजन। सिमिलरली इफ योर मार्क्स आर ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 40 एंड लेस देन 50, वंस अगेन इट इज कम्बाइंड विद दिस पर्टिकुलर लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर, सो वी हैव अवॉइडेड नेस्टेड इफ स्टेटमेंट एंड वी आर टेस्टिंग द टू कंडीशंस साइमल्टेनियसली एंड कम्बाइनिंग देम इंटेलिजेंटली विद दिस लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर एंड एंड देन वी प्रिंट थर्ड डिविजन। इफ परसेंटेज इज लेस देन 40, अगर इधर से नहीं ट्रू फिर इधर जाएगा, ये ट्रू नहीं है तो इधर जाएगा, ये ट्रू नहीं है तो इधर जाएगा, एंड अगर इनमें से कहीं नहीं गया देन इट्स प्रॉब्लम, देन इट्स मीन दैट द परसेंटेज इज लेस देन 40, प्रिंट एफ। ओके, सो वी हैव अवॉइडेड नेस्टेड स्ट्रक्चर एंड वी हैव सीन द बेनिफिट्स ऑफ द लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर। द मैचिंग ऑफ द इफ्स विद देयर कॉरस्पॉन्डिंग एल्सेस गेट्स अवॉइडेड सिंस देयर आर नो एल्स इन दिस प्रोग्राम। इसमें कोई एल्स हमने यूज ही नहीं किए, सीधी इफ स्टेटमेंट्स यूज किए। ओके, दूसरा, डिस्पाइट ऑफ यूजिंग सेवरल कंडीशंस द प्रोग्राम डजंट क्रीप टू द राइट। नेस्टेड में क्या करता है, वो राइट साइड पे खुलता चला जाता है प्रोग्राम आपका। ठीक, तो ऑल्दो वी हैव टेस्टेड ऑल द कंडीशंस, लेकिन हमारा प्रोग्राम जो है स्टिल फ्लश टूवर्ड्स लेफ्ट, और इसकी रीडेबिलिटी जो है प्रोग्राम की इज मोर रीडेबल। ओके, एक और कॉम्बिनेशन, यू मे राइट टू यूज इफ एल्स, सिमिलरली यू कैन यूज एल्स इफ। वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग, सेम थिंग यू कैन डू दैट, बट दिस टाइम यू कंबाइंड द इफ विद, इंस्टेड ऑफ कंबाइनिंग इफ विद एल्स, यू आर कंबाइनिंग एल्स विद इफ। सो M1, M2, M3, M5, clear screen, enter the data, compute the average, print the percentage average. If the percentage is greater than equal to 60, print first division, else, अब आप टेस्ट लगा रहे। If the percentage is greater than equal to 50, इसका मतलब है understood है, आपने इसको इसके साथ combined किया ना, and खुद ब खुद हो गया। जब ये if और else लगी तो and खुद हो गया कि परसेंटेज ग्रेटर देन इक्वल टू 60 तो है ही नहीं, इसका मतलब है कि 60 से कम है, बट इफ इट इज ग्रेटर देन 50 तो इसका मतलब है कि इट इज ग्रेटर देन 50 एंड लेस देन 60, तो वो जो एंड वाला काम है वो एल्स इफ से हो रहा है। एंड देन वंस अगेन एल्स इफ, दैट विल इंश्योर इट इज नॉट ग्रेटर देन 60, दैट विल इंश्योर इट इज नॉट ग्रेटर देन 50, इट्स मीन दैट एल्स इफ percentage is greater than equal to 40, इसका मतलब है कि the result are between 40 to 49, second division. And last, क्योंकि now you are just left with one condition, third division, अब not else if, final, last else goes to the final if statement, इसके साथ print fail. Okay, so we have learned another construct which is called the else if construct. Okay, the program reduces the indentation of the statements. In this case, every else is associated with its previous if, jo bhi maine aapko bataya. The last else goes to work only if all the conditions fails. The else if clause is just a way of rearranging the else with the if that follows it. क्या मतलब, मतलब ये Okay, this if you have combined with else if, but this if you have combined with else if, and the last else goes to the last if. This else goes with this if, this else goes with this if. Okay, and last else goes with this if, as if ke ye aapka ek statement ban gayi. If percentage is greater than or equal to 40, print third division as print fail. ठीक है? और बाकी हमने इसको logic भी combine किया, जो इसका काम था, like we have taken it with the logical operator, ends operator के साथ जो हम काम ले रहे थे, वो हमने else if से काम ले ली. Let's take the clause 3 that we have discussed previous week. But the example, if the percentage is greater than equal to 60, first division, else. If percentage is greater than equal to 50, print second division, closed. Now you have used another if statement separately. If percentage is greater than equal to 60, print f first division. Else if percentage is greater than equal to 50, print f second division. यही जो हमने ऊपर काम किया था, वही काम हमने आपको दो तरीके से करके दिखाया. Okay, not operator. आज हमने कोई और की एक्सरसाइज नहीं की है, हमने एंड की एक्सरसाइज की है, but I would like to show you the not operator all. The not operator is often used to reverse the logic value. Not true means false. Not false means true. Not variable means if a flag, not flag means the flag is not true, means the flag is false. This is another way of saying flag equal zero. Agar zero hoti hai to usse kya kehte hai? False. Or if flag means if flag is true. Jab maine kaha if not flag, iska matlab hai if flag is not true. क्या टेस्ट कर रहा हूं? If the flag is false, तो हम रिवर्स टेस्ट करने के लिए यूज कर सकते हैं. जैसे हम कहते हैं कि if the flag equal zero, सेम थिंग we can test it here with the sign of exclamation, not flag. Is it just like if flag equal to zero? It performs the not operation. That may sound confusing, but it's very very useful. Avoid if you want, as the same thing can be achieved without using it. But there are certain cases where you say that if not true instead of saying if false. Okay, documentation purpose may you might require if not false means true, so you are required to use it. But if you can live without it, you can leave it. Let's take the example. मैंने आपसे कहा था दिस ऑपरेटर रिवर्स द रिजल्ट ऑफ द एक्सप्रेशन. इट ऑपरेट्स ऑन इफ द एक्सप्रेशन वैल्यूएट्स टू अ नॉन जीरो वैल्यू, देन अप्लाइंग नॉट ऑपरेटर टू इट रिजल्ट्स इनटू अ जीरो. यानी कि अगर आंसर आपका ट्रू आ रहा है तो उसके पीछे नॉट लगा दें तो उसका आंसर जीरो हो जाएगा, और अगर आंसर आपका जीरो आ रहा है तो उसके पीछे नॉट लगा दें, आंसर आपका ट्रू हो जाएगा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, if not y is less than 10, y 10 से less नहीं है, y is less than 10, not less than 10, इसका मतलब है कि y is greater than equal to 10. अगर not less than 10 होगा तो understood है कि y is greater than equal to 10, ठीक है, because it is not less than 10. So we can express the same condition saying that y is greater than equal to 10. Okay, students, we have seen the operators now, we have seen the logical operators, we have seen the arithmetic operators. So hierarchy mein iski precedence ke andar sabse pehle sign of exclamation, logical not execute hota hai because it stays outside, or it is basically a unary operator. Unary means ke jiska ek operand hai, binary jiske do operands hai. नेक्स्ट प्रेसिडेंस होता है मल्टीप्लीकेशन, डिवीजन एंड मॉडुलस और मॉडुलो. नेक्स्ट प्रेसिडेंस आपको पता है प्लस एंड माइनस. तो अरिथमेटिक का प्रेसिडेंस इज हायर देन द रिलेशन, duration of precedence. आपको मैंने एक एग्जांपल में भी बताया था, 1 plus 2 is less than 3, plus पहले execute हो रहा था, तो it has got the higher precedence. Okay, तो ये precedence इस तरीके से जा रहा है ऊपर, सबसे ऊपर इसका, then multiplication, division, modulus, plus and minus, और whichever comes first from left to right, normally हमारे relational operators में एक operator होता है, so we can say that yes, we can use it like this. Similarly, equality and not equality, then the logical AND, logical OR, or assignment. आज हमने कोई भी operator जो है, OR operator नहीं पढ़ा, but I promise that we'll be using it very shortly in the next lectures. Okay. Dear students, there are certain errors which are hard to debug. क्योंकि आपको पता नहीं चलता कि आपने mistake क्या की है, बड़ी छोटी सी mistake है, and it is putting you in trouble, and you don't find, and you say that, कि रिजल्ट जवाब सही नहीं आ रहा. So let's take an example. Enter value of I. Read the value of I. If I equal 5, print f, you have entered 5. Else, print f, you entered something other than 5. Now suppose you type 200. तो इसको क्या लिखना चाहिए? इसको प्रिंट करना चाहिए क्या? You entered something other than 5. But it will say you entered 5. भाई इधर कैसे चला गया है कंट्रोल? ओके, कंट्रोल शुड नॉट गो हियर. तो व्हाट मिस्टेक वी हैव डन हियर? कैन यू फाइंड आउट द मिस्टेक? जस्ट कॉन्सेंट्रेट हियर इन दिस स्टेटमेंट. डिड यू सी समथिंग? इफ आई इक्वल 5, कुछ पता चला? ये क्या है? This sign is assignment operator, not the equality operator. ये testing के भी use नहीं होगा. इसका purpose है R value to be assigned to the L value. So 5 is assigned to I first. When it will assign 5 to I, which is non-zero, so it will be true. So it's mean that the result of this if statement is true and the control comes up here and it will print you entered 5. It will not like this. Similarly, if you even if you enter 9994 times, yet it will say 5. Why? कि आपने यहाँ पर equality operators की बजाय which were like this instead of using these two operators, equality operators, you have used just assignment operator. So assignment operator to value assign kar dega variable ko, which is a non-zero value, which is computed as non-zero. Kaise compute hota? It is computed as true, and if it is true, then it will print a wrong thing. And this type of error, believe me, is very difficult to debug. Let's take another example. Integer I, print f, enter value of I, read the value of I. If I equal 5, you entered 5. If I equal 5, you entered 5. Whatever you enter, it will print 5. Why? A very small mistake. You have used, आपको याद है मैंने कहा था don't use semicolon with if test. This is be converted as if you have written like this. So body of the statement क्या है? सिर्फ semicolon. Or if you are using only semicolon, then this is a statement which is a null statement. It is a null statement. Okay? It is a null statement. So iska matlab hai ki if I is equal to 5, do nothing. Or then the control will come up to the next statement and it will print you entered 5. This is not the body of this if statement. अगर फर्ज करें आप यूज करना चाहते हैं दोनों स्टेटमेंट, तो फिर यू जस्ट पुट ये यहां पर, देन इट बिकम्स द बॉडी. बट सिंस यू हैव नॉट यूज दीज कर्वी ब्रैकेट्स, देयरफॉर इट दिस सेमी कॉलन which could be here or which could be here. White space hai na enter yahan par. Jo aapne enter kiya to yahan pe aa gaya. If you don't enter it, it will be here. So it will be treated as the body of the if statement. So if statement, whatever the result of the statement is, it will do nothing. So even if you enter 0, it will say you entered 5. And this error is again hard to debug. Okay, how can we combine these logical operators? Operands ke hain do two values hain. Okay, let us see. Suppose the value of x is equal to 0 and value of y is equal to 0. Then what is the value of not x? Not x kya karega? X ki value ko reverse kar dega. If x is 0, not x is 1. Not y is 1. X and y, x or y, if x is false, y is false, the result is false. X or y, if x is 0, y is 0, the result is 0. This is called the truth table. This is the table of the logical operators. Suppose x is 0, y is non-zero. Not x, 0 ka not x 1, it will become true. Not y, non-zero is true. So not y becomes false, it will become 0. X or y ko end karein, answer is equal to 0. Because when you end, you multiply. X or y, non-zero, it's a mistake. It should be equal to 1. Okay? Because either 0, x is true or y is true, the result is true. In dono mein se koi ek bhi value true ho jaye, to answer is true. Okay? So, isko 0 nahi hona chahiye, isko 1 hona chahiye. X is non-zero, y is 0, not x, non-zero se 0, not y, 1, and dono ka 0. Or, since this is non-zero, so x is true or y is true, therefore answer is true. Dono mein se ek bhi quantity true ho, to answer is equal to true. This is non-zero, this is non-zero. Therefore, not x is 0, not y is 0. So, x and y, both is equal to 1. Ab aapne end kiya, maine aapse kaha tha, end mein dono quantities aap assume kare, multiply hoti hai. Since both are 1, therefore the answer should be equal to 1. Or, 1 plus 1 is again, 1 means A is true, B is true, answer is true. So this is a very good table to remember that how these logical operators are computed. If the values are 0 or 1, means 0 stands for false, 1 stands for true, or non-zero stands for true. Okay, please remember that. Now finally, the last topic of this lecture is the conditional operator. This conditional operator is basically a combination of question mark and semicolon. We combine these two operators together. So they take three arguments. One before this, second in between, third is here. There are three arguments. They form a kind of four shorthand, if then else. If then else ko hum teen jagah par yahan par replace kar sakte hain conditional operator se, but it's very tricky to operate. For example, you can say that integer x comma y, you read the value of x. So we say y is equal to x greater than 5 question mark 3 colon 4. So this is argument number 1, which is a test. We say that if x is 5, if the result is true, the answer should be 3. If the result is false, then the answer of this expression is 4. I repeat again slowly. First one is called test. This is called true. If true, then this is the answer. If false, then this is the answer. So the answer is either true or false. In case the answer of this expression, test expression, is true, the answer is true, this one. If the test expression answer is false, then the value of this expression is whatever you have provided it here. Okay, so answer kya aayega iska? Let us see. Suppose we have entered x is equal to 6. If x is equal to 6 means x is greater than 5, true, then the answer is equal to 3. So y will have a value equal to 3. It is equivalent to the if statement. If x is greater than 5, if yes, y is equal to 3, else y is equal to 4. वही चीज़ जो मैं आपको एक्सप्लेन कर रहा था. इधर अगर आप इफ और एल्स के कंस्ट्रक्ट में देखें कि इफ द रिजल्ट इज ट्रू देन द आंसर इज बिफोर द क्वेश्चन मार्क, सॉरी जस्ट आफ्टर द क्वेश्चन मार्क दिस, देन द आंसर इज दिस, और इफ दिस इज फॉल्स देन इट गोज हेयर एंड देन द लास्ट वन इज हेयर. ओके, सो दैट इज अनदर वे ऑफ यूजिंग द इफ एंड एल्स यूजिंग कंडीशनल ऑपरेटर. लेट्स टेक अनदर form of this conditional operator. Arithmetic statements ke bhi use hi nahi karna, but you can use it to for any statements also. For example, we can say if I is equal to 1, print 1, else print not 1. Means this is a test part. If I is equal to 1, if this is true, then it will print this part. And if the result is not true, then it will result this part. So if I is equal to 1, it will print 1. If I is not equal to 1, it will print not 1. Similarly, very interesting example here. Suppose you have defined a character A which has a value Z. Now we say printf percentage C. If A is greater than 123, Z ka code hai, if I remember it correctly, it is less than 123. Okay, it is something because small a is a, so z should be equal to 122, I guess. So it is not greater than 123, rather it is 123. So this test expression result is false. If it is false, then it will print out. इस परसेंट सी को जो आर्गुमेंट असाइन होगा वो ए असाइन नहीं होगा. इट विल नॉट प्रिंट जी, इट विल प्रिंट दिस साइन ऑफ एक्सक्लेमेशन. ओके, मेरा ख्याल है जी का कोड इज 123. आई विल चेक इट आउट एंड लेट यू नो. आप इतना भी कर सकते हैं कि ए का जो कोड है दैट इज इक्वल टू 97, बी इज 98, C is 99, D is 100, is then calculate karein, find out what is the code of Z. So you should be able to find it out. But I'm sure it is less than or equal to 123. So that's why I've written here, it will print this sign of exclamation. Okay, very interesting. Let's see another combination of this. You can use it with the conditional operators also. So what will be the value of big this? So this is the test. If the A is greater than B, so what is the value of A is 3, B is 2, C is 1. If A is greater than B, if it is true, then execute this statement. Otherwise, execute this statement. Very nice. So this is nested conditional operator. Since A is 3, B is 2, this is true, so it will execute this statement. When it will execute this statement, then if A is greater than C, yes, A is greater than C because A is 3, B is, C is 1. So if it is true, the answer should be this 3. Okay? So its output is equal to 3. Or agar A ki value hoti 1, B ki 2, C ki 3, to ye false ho jata. A is less than B ho jata, kyunki hum assume karte hain ki value 1, B की वैल्यू 2 और C की वैल्यू 3. सो A इज लेस देन B, यस, नो, A इज नॉट ग्रेटर देन B, सो दिस ट्रू, सो इट शुड हैव एग्जीक्यूटेड दिस फॉल्स पार्ट. हियर वी से दैट इफ B इज ग्रेटर देन C, नो, B इज नॉट ग्रेटर देन C, वंस अगेन इट इज फॉल्स, सो द आंसर उसका आता 8. The same example is given below. If A is 1, B is 2, C is 3, मैंने ऑलरेडी इसको एक्सप्लेन कर दिया आपके लिए. Good. Conditional operator 4. If A is greater than B, question mark, G is equal to A, question mark, G is equal to B. Here, it will give you an error message which will say that L value required, kyunki yahan par it is finished. Okay, it will say G. A is greater than B, question mark, G is equal to A, as G, whatever the value of G is. So if you want that this G is equal to B should be executed, then you put this parenthesis here. It will force that the value of B is assigned to G, and then depending upon the result, it will be executed. Okay? Please spend some time in it and code it in your environment. जो मैंने आपको टेम्पलेट दिया है वो वर्ड का, उसमें आप ये लिखते चले जाएं एंड यू विल फाइंड द रिजल्ट बाय योरसेल्फ. द लिमिटेशन ऑफ द कंडीशनल ऑपरेटर इज दैट आफ्टर द क्वेश्चन मार्क और आफ्टर द कोलन ओनली वन सी स्टेटमेंट कैन अकर, जबकि इफ स्टेटमेंट में ऐसी कोई कंडीशन नहीं है. If or else के अंदर you can put in as many statement as you like, just you need to put in a braces. जबकि conditional operator के अंदर you can only put only one single statement. If it is true, then you can put one statement. If it is false, then you can only put one statement. So that is the major difference. So in serious C programming, conditional operators are not used frequently. Rather we use if and else. Summary, finally. We are coming to the end of the lecture. There are three ways of for taking decision in a program. First way is to use the if else statement. Second way is to use the conditional operators, and third way is to use the switch statement. The default scope of the if statement is only the next statement. So to execute more than one statement, they must be written in a pair of braces. By default, body of the if statement is considered to be a single statement. Chahe wo if ki body ho, chahe wo else ki body ho. So if you want to put more statement, then you have to put it into the braces. An if block need not always be associated with an else block. However, an else block is always associated with if. If तो बगैर else के हो सकता है, else बगैर if के नहीं हो सकता. That is the simple statement. If you are having an if statement, you may not be having any else statement. But if you are using an else statement, then you must use the if part also. That is important. क्योंकि बजाते खुद if statement environment है, else statement environment नहीं है. By default, if statement का पार्ट है else स्टेटमेंट. इफ द आउटकम ऑफ द इफ else लैडर इज ओनली वन और टू आंसर्स, देन द लैडर शुड बी रिप्लेस आइदर विद else if caused और बाय लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर्स. अगर दो में से एक आउटकम आना है तो else यूज करवें उसके साथ, या लॉजिकल ऑपरेटर्स को कंबाइन करवें. ठीक. एंड और आर बाइनरी ऑपरेटर्स. क्यों? इसके दो ऑपरेंड्स हैं, ए एंड बी. ए और बी दे हैव गॉट टू ऑपरेटर्स, सो दे आर कॉल्ड बाइनरी ऑपरेटर. वेयर एज नॉट इज अ यूनरी ऑपरेटर, नॉट एक्स, सो इट हैज गॉट वन ऑपरेंड, नॉट वाई, इट हैज गॉट वन ऑपरेंड. इन सी एवरी टेस्ट एक्सप्रेशन इज इवैल्यूएटेड इन टर्म्स ऑफ जीरो और वन, फॉल्स और ट्रू. A zero value is considered to be false and non-zero value is considered to be true. Assignment statement used with conditional operator must be enclosed within a pair of parentheses. जब आप assign करते हैं, क्योंकि without assigning, it assumes that the quantity, the data of that variable is picked up. But if you want to use an assignment operator, then you must put it into the parentheses so that it should be executed first to a single operand, to a single value, then you can use it. So, dear student, that is the end of today's lecture. Today we have learned some very, very important construct, which is called if construct. And I have blended this particular lesson with relational operators as well as with logical operators. आपने देखा कि इसके बगैर हम if और else को डिटेल में स्टडी नहीं कर सकते थे. That's why मैंने आपसे लास्ट लेक्चर में प्रॉमिस किया था कि we will discuss it, discuss all the logical operators and relational operators at an appropriate place. तो अब सिर्फ एक ऑपरेटर रह गए, वो कौन से? बिट वाइज ऑपरेटर. वंस अगेन आई प्रॉमिस यू डैट एट अ सर्टन टाइम वी विल बी फोकसिंग एंड डिस्कसिंग द बिट वाइज ऑपरेटर्स. सो प्लीज गो थ्रू द लेक्चर वेरी केयरफुली. इफ यू डोंट अंडरस्टैंड समथिंग, रिपीट इट वंस, ट्वाइस, थ्राइस. एंड येट इफ यू डोंट फाइंड द राइट आंसर एंड डोंट अंडरस्टैंड एनी कॉन्सेप्ट, प्लीज कॉन्टेक्ट अस थ्रू द कोर्स पोर्टल. ओके, खुदा हाफिज़.